Welcome to the ancestral home of Yurok, Wia, and Talawa peoples in Trinidad Bay, where I hope to show you some interesting things in the Intertidal Zone. Are you familiar with the Intertidal Zone? If you've been to the ocean, you may have noticed that the water waves don't stay in the same place. The tide comes in and out during the day. The Intertidal Zone is that area between the highest tide and the lowest tide. At low tide, the ocean waters are furthest away from the coast, exposing rocks and interesting critters for us to see. As the ocean waters retreat, tide pools are formed in the shallow depressions of this rugged seascape. We're here to catch critters hunkering down in the rocky tide pools to learn how animals live and survive in this unique coastal habitat. Due to the harsh conditions here, not all animals will survive, and some do better than others because of certain abilities. So keep track of any animals we can find and see if you can spot them hanging tight or huddling up. But be warned, animals in the Intertidal Zone like to hide.
Some of the critters in the Intertidal Zone have to hang tight to protect themselves from the rough waves. Sea stars and barnacles attach themselves to rocks. Sea stars use hundreds of tube feet to cling to surfaces like a suction cup. And barnacles use a specially made glue to anchor their heads to the wall, where they spend most of their life. When the tide comes in, barnacles use their feet to catch nutrients floating in the water. The ocean waters are swarming with tiny critters that could grow to be snails, crabs, and even jellyfish. Though full of life, the rough seas are strong enough to strip some of these permanent residents from their home. As you can see, life in the Intertidal Zone is harsh, but just like you, animals here know that life is always cooler when you're with your friends. That's why critters huddle up, to keep from drying once the tide is low and it starts to get hot. Huddling up helps animals stay cool, so a solitary animal is more likely to overheat than one living in a cluster. Crowding together also helps animals avoid predators, which is great when you consider that there are two things to do in the Intertidal Zone: munch or become someone else's lunch. Critters hunkering down in cracks and crevices have to come out of hiding so they can eat. Animals that live attached to a surface depend on the sea to bring their next meal. That's how we know that these closed-in enemies are underwater more often. Look how much they've eaten compared to these little ones up here. When anemones are underwater, they use their tentacles to sting and paralyze their prey. Can you see the meal this giant green anemone scored? The tide delivered lunch today, but tomorrow it may deliver a hungry sea slug. Let's hope that sea star has already eaten. Because unless an animal can hide, who eats who depends on the tide and which pool critters end up in.
Thank you for exploring the Intertidal Zone with me today. I had a lot of fun learning how animals live and survive in this unique coastal habitat. Hopefully my tide pooling friend and I found enough critters for you to see that some animals survive better than others here because of certain abilities like hanging tight, huddling up, and hiding. I hope you have an opportunity to visit a rocky intertidal area near you. And remember, take nothing but pictures, learning, and memories.